Did you have a number in mind, what you're trying to get for it?
Well, we're trying to get a spot. Spot's 2,000 right now.
Did you have a number in mind, what you're trying to get for it?
Well, we're trying to get a spot. Spot's 2,000 right now. 2,002, something like that.
Oh, I think it's dropped today a little bit. Right now it is 1989.
So it's close enough. You got a little platinum in there, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, just for me, loose like this, I'd pay like 90% on it.
I'd probably take it
then.
Yeah. I got it from SD Bullion.
Yeah, I don't think he does spot either, does he?
Yeah.
Does he?
Mm-hmm.
I would say it's probably.
If I go to Vermilion, I get spot plus two, you know.
Yeah.
Have you done it lately? Because everybody's selling it. Have you tried lately? Because it's just.
2 months ago. I get it. Loaded. It's a selling market. I get it.
Within the last weeks, it's been unreal what people are bringing.
Okay.
I don't know why, but I mean, if he's doing spot, that's good.
Are you going to do what? You say you're going to 90%? What is that?
Like 1,800, somewhere around there.
I saw your favorite coin. You got the fun show on YouTube. That's cool.
Did you?
Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah. The flowing hair.
Yeah.
I love that thing.
I'm looking at one of those dollars. With a whole dollar, he's got one that's whole that's like $500. Like, you know, I might just get that. You know, you can't
sometimes,
get a tight collection done without it.
Sometimes
you know
the whole dollars it takes away from the value a lot.
Sometimes
it'll even, it doesn't ever add to it, but sometimes it doesn't. So with different coins, I've just seen it. It's weird.
You know, it's hard to pop $2,000 on an old dollar like that. You know what I'm saying?
It's hard. Like,
you're never going to get it back.
Mine was like $1,500, $1,450.
Right. It's hard to ever get that back. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah, he had a nice hold one the last time. I might get it next time I go there.
Flowing hair.
That's why I came over here so we can go over there.
He had a flowing hair.
Huh?
A flowing hair.
Yeah, it was like a 1798 silver dollar.
That's not flowing hair.
No,
yeah,
it's not quite. It's 1794 for that.
That's the next one.
Yeah, it's the next one up from there, but.
Probably the Drake bust or something.
Yeah,
like
but
that.
You got to get, you know, getting back there is entertaining. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I saw you when you got that one at the gift. Like,
I've got
that's
nothing
serious
against
stuff
him.
There.
You just got to watch. I've never bought anything there because he is a little bit high on the stuff. But I got nothing against him. He's a good guy. He's a nice guy. I got nothing bad to say about him. But you just got to watch. If you go to the coin shows, I'm telling you, that's what to do. If you guys like coin shows,
we went to fun last year.
Yeah, that's pretty much where you're going to find the flowing heritage. Is tough right now. Man, you can't find them anywhere.
Yeah, that's true.
What do you think?
Yeah, the best I've been on is like 1850 on it.
That's like 90-something percent.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
We're not going to run around town for that. We'll take it.
If you want to do that.
Yeah.
It's just, I'm scared, man, to pay that and then gold drop to 1850 and then, you know, what do you do with it then?
Yeah,
you know what I'm
saying?
You
got the war going on though too, so you think it's going up too, so that's why it's up and down. Yeah, I get it. It was just at 1850.
Yeah.
It was just at 1850. It's all over the place.
So it's hard for me, man. I know that, and they're basically coin shops, and the other thing is too, I like to price mine a little bit cheaper than everybody else, because if everybody prices the same, you know, you could buy them anywhere for whatever all them are charging over.
I get. You're trying to sell it for $2,000.
You want to start?
I just need an ID.
Sure. If I went over there, I would have spent $500 on coins without thinking.
That's the other thing, yeah.
That's why I said to come over. I said, let's go over here. If I go over there, I'm going to buy something bigger.
He's got a lot of nice stuff. I would have bought a lot of stuff, but everything is just that little bit too.
You got to want it too. It's got to be something that you want, you know?
Yeah.
You know, if you're doing type coins, he's got a little of everything. You know what I'm saying? You really, they got the inventory is big what they got.
Well, he's really the only show in town, too. There aren't any. There's no coin stores around, coin shops around here.
Yeah, the there's not a lot around here. Yeah. You got to go up to Orlando or something. You know, I'm not in the mood.
I think it's so hard, man. I think it's so hard to make, you know, enough of what rent and all that's costing nowadays to keep a brick and mortar open because it's so competitive now.
Yeah. Everything's tough because everything's online.
Yeah.
You know, you can go to Atmix and get anything, you know.
Yeah. And then well, there's a lot of like coin dealers. Like if you have Instagram, Instagram's huge right now for coins. There's a lot of people that do Instagram for coins and stuff. But
it's tough because you got to get something you want. You know what I mean? You're either getting bullion or you're getting doing coins that you really want to have. You know what I'm saying? It's like I like those gold $10 like the Standing Liberty, like the Walking Liberty, and they had that one series that came out with the gold, and they got the little Mercury and stuff like that. Yeah, I got the gold $10 of that one with that, you know, Walking Liberty on it. You know, I love that coin. You know what I'm saying? But you know, I paid up for a little bit for it, but not too bad. At least I put it in a case and kept it clean, so that somebody wants it clean, right?
Yeah. You have a lot of coins, or just a.
A lot is a kind of a vague term. I got it a good bit of stuff. Yeah. I got a bunch of stuff.
I don't guess I have a lot. I only got like maybe 10 gold coins. I got some silver coins. I don't have a lot.
You got what you want to have.
But yeah,
that's what it's
anytime
about.
I get more than that, I just get to where it's like, what do I really need
you
more?
Can turn it out and get something else that you really like.
That's kind of what I did with that flowing hair.
I saw that, man. Well, that's killer, that one there.
Yeah,
like,
I lucked into that. We went through the whole show all day, like 6 hours.
I know, I said that.
Table to table to table, asking every table, and not one person. Yeah. It was either $10,000 or one you couldn't read,
right,
or they didn't have it.
It's tough stuff.
So that guy had it behind the counter. He said, I have one, but I'm holding it for somebody. And we were like, well, when did he come in? Or, you know, is he going to buy it?
Right.
You know, he was here this morning. He said he was going to come back, and I've never seen him again. And I was like, if you want to sell it, I'll buy it.
Right.
And so the only reason I got it, I think, is because he had it behind the counter. Yeah, I wouldn't have got it if he...
Yeah, that's cool stuff.
I don't think I'd have got
it. I might go get that, you know, get a low-grade one, you know.
That's what I did. It was an 8, I think mine, 6 or 8 mine was.
That's
so you
bad.
Can read it, it's nice.
It's not bad.
And it was like 1400. I think the book was like 13-something, and I think it sells for around... 15, 16.
That's
so I
not
mean,
bad.
It wasn't bad, but I always like to try to get the best deal on that stuff I can. Just push down on that pretty good with your right thumb. 20, 40, 60, 83,
20, 40, 18,
50.
Sounds great. Well, appreciate y'all. Well,
I appreciate all you right, bringing man. It in.
Yeah.
Oh,
I'll take it if you don't want it. That's a new one. My wife usually take all the money, you know. I was like,
hey,
my pockets are clean. She's got it. What do you got on your neck?
This is from El Cazador.
What that is?
The ship.
Yeah, that's pirate's money there.
Yeah.
That's
sank
cool stuff.
In 1783, and they found it in like 1994.
That's cool. Yeah, watch. She's got the Hoover brothers. You ever see the Hoover brothers?
Oh yeah.
Oh, they're always digging up that
they're
stuff there. So
that
now I wanted to get a real sometime. You know, it's like.
They get them. They get them.
I know.
They don't get the old ones like that, but they get like from the 1790s.
Yeah.
Believe it or not, a fisherman found this one.
That right.
Got his nets hung and pulled it up.
That's weird stuff.
That's the only Metal channel I really watch is the Hoover Boys.
Yeah, they're funny.
I like them.
They're entertaining.
Yeah.
We'll play again.
All right. Thanks.
Appreciate y'all.
All righty.
I'm not paying. I can't. You just can't pay spot, man. What if silver drops back down to 18, or what if gold drops back down to 1850 like it has?
It's never going to go to 22, 23. It ain't going to make them big jumps up. It'll make the jump down. It won't make that big jump up. Not usually.
How much is the video game stuff?
How much is the video game?
$2 a piece.
A dollar.
She's over there.
Oh, okay.
Would you do a deal on the whole box?
I don't think you heard me though. I said, how much?
Oh, okay.
Honestly, I don't even know what's in there.
How much is it?
We've got a PS3 in there.
I'm sorry.
These probably don't do with anything.
Okay.
Oh, Xbox stuff.
Yeah.
real balloon is, some of these probably aren't anything at all. I don't know, make me an offer on the damn box.
How many things in here? I'm trying to get it. You don't have these, the DS games, do you?
I don't know. See, if my sons are probably
they're not in there.
Some of these he may not have the boxes for.
Bunch of 360 games. I seen a case for that, maybe.
What's that?
I seen a case for that game, maybe, somewhere.
Oh,
yeah, I think so.
Like I say, some of this stuff was my son's, so.
Yeah.
And he told me, he says, I didn't keep very many of my games in the boxes.
Yeah.
There's quite a few Xbox games on this.
Sucks this game in there. And you don't have any more DS games or anything like this, do you? The handheld stuff?
Actually, he just bought a DS and reconfigured it.
Yeah.
Put an extra screen on it. I don't know, something that's popular now with kids.
Do you resell?
I have a pawn shop, so I do put games in the pawn shop and stuff like that. And I look for all that kind of stuff and. Yes, ma'am.
I wondered how they filmed it.
Yeah.
I didn't think they held the camera.
What would you take for the box?
$5. Thank you. Appreciate it.
I like her price.
$30.
Yeah, why not? You said you have a PS3 too, or not? You don't want to sell it?
I guess.
Can I see which?
Let me go get it real quick.
What it is, or what? If you have any other games or anything like that too?
No. Well, everything's going to digital now, so you download everything.
Yeah.
Here's the console. I don't know where the controllers are at.
Yeah, this one's the. Here's the.
Yeah, that was the.
What'd you want for it?
$25 for just to get rid of it.
Yeah.
You're already getting all the games. You got a pawn shop, you can probably sell it to somebody.
Yeah, PS3s are tough unless they're like the backwards compatible one, and this one isn't. Yeah. If you set it out, man, you'll probably sell it, but I'd probably pass on it.
Yeah.
I appreciate it. You don't have any old cartridge systems or games, do you? Like Nintendo 64 or Super Nintendo, anything like that?
Actually, I sold one about 3 years ago. Yeah. I had an old, I think it was a Nintendo 64 Star Wars edition.
Yeah.
I was talking to somebody about it, and his daughter wanted it bad. He had a game store down in Seaver.
Okay. And oh, I probably know. Did he have long hair? Guy with long hair?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, I know him. I know him. He has a game store in Seaver.
Like a vintage game
shop
in the mall.
Yep. All right, well, I appreciate it.
No, thank you.
Locking the game shelf back up.
Must be good shoes.
Yeah, they're
$300. Hey, I'll show my son. I gotta.
Okay.
Books are $1.
Piece,
yeah, $1
a piece.
Okay. Okay. It's for the book.
Okay.
FaceTime Justin.
Starting a FaceTime call to Justin iPhone.
Okay. I'll show him the shoes. Hey, he said these are $100 each, but he said they're like $300. I don't know what he's got the receipts and stuff. There's them.
What size are they?
And there's them. They're 100 each, or how? 100 for all, 100 for each?
100 each, they're expensive. They got about $300.
They're 300?
What size are they?
They're slightly used. I mean, only on the bottom. The tops look really good.
What size are they?
5 youth, 5 Y.
The bottom of them, take like both of your thumbs and put them side by side and push where like the middle of your foot would be and see if it's soft. Is it hard or is it soft? Like, does it push in easy?
No, it's hard. It doesn't push in easy at all.
Like where you're, like right behind your toes, where like your foot starts to get like right in there.
Right here?
A little bit more. Yeah, no, down a little bit.
I mean, it's
where that circle is, yeah, like right there. Like put both your thumbs side by side and push down. Is it soft or is it hard?
I mean, it feels hard, but I mean, I don't know.
But the same thing is.
I guess it ain't soft.
Well, I mean, it don't like push in like unusually or like.
No, it feels good. It feels strong.
Yeah. It's just, let me see. That's. It's just a 5. It's just a kid size, man.
There's a receipt in here. I don't know if this is where these came from or what, but I mean, it's a kid size 5.
That's what Alani wears, but I mean,
she dropped the price she had for 180. She put a 100 today. Yeah.
Oh, it says 6.
That's the 6?
Yeah, it's size 6.
That's Alani size.
Yeah.
Would she do 150 on the blue and red ones or not?
He said, would you do 150 for the 2?
Yeah.
It's getting late.
Yeah, that's fine.
Is that all right? She said she'll do 150 for the 2 of them. You want to look at them again? Are you good? Because I'm telling you, man, I don't know.
They're fine. They should be good.
Well, I don't want to get them there and then you say, man, you should have been able to tell easy on these things.
I promise.
Well, I mean, what is it?
I promise they're like real.
Okay. He's worried because there's so many fakes.
They're real.
I believe you, but I mean,
the only reason I'm getting rid of the red ones because those are like, I got them in 2016 and I'm like, I don't wear them. We're moving. They're
2016?
Too big.
Since you got them in 2016.
But I don't wear them. But if you look at them, I look them up online, they're worth like $300, $400.
Are they? I don't know them. I know he just left my son and he likes them for his kids. And I'm scared to
they're
buy
like
stuff.
Collecting.
And then. So you want the 2 or you want to look at them again? Are you good?
It should be good.
So 150 or 75 a piece is what you're doing. All right. And you don't want the white ones?
No, I'm for 100 now.
Well, you don't want them for no less?
No, and then they're a 4 is like an in-between size. Them dudes get to a 3 and a lot of
right.
6.
All right, well, I got them. I'm going to come looking for you if they're fake. I'm messing with you. Once I buy it, they're mine. So, do you want your sign or is that okay? Or?
No, it's fine.
It's good? Okay. All right. Thanks.
So before we close out the video, I just want to talk to you about a few things that we bought. First being the Gold Buffalo. I always have people in the videos that say, you should rip them off. You should have paid spot. It's gold, whatever. But from a business standpoint, it's just not worth me putting out $2,000 and maybe make $100. Because if I put out two, if gold is 2,000, I pay him 2,000, and gold drops to 1,900, then what do you do with it? You're going to break even on it at best. So from a business standpoint, it's just not worth doing that. Silver, you can kind of do it. You can pay spot for silver for the Silver Eagles because your percentage is still there. You know, you can get $4 or $5 over, and your percentage is still there to make your money. But on a 1 ounce gold like that, and the way gold moves, you know, it's $100 swings up or down, it's just not worth it. And people say, well, it could go up. Well, I'm not in the business to gamble. When I like to gamble, I go to the casino. And then for us too, like you see my dad buy the other thing we bought was my dad bought the book. He paid $1 for it, listed it for $150. So we find stuff like that all the time. So, you know, we put out $1 and make $150. So for us to put out $2,000 and maybe make $100, it's just, it's not worth it. No matter what anybody says, no matter what other places do, it's just not worth it from a business standpoint. The second thing you see me buy was a bunch of video games. So in those video games, it was sucked that that Pokemon game wasn't in there. There ended up being 65 games total. So I had like 45 cent in them a piece. So that most of that stuff goes to the $5 shelf. If you're buying strictly for eBay, you know, you might want to go through there and cherry pick the stuff to buy. But for me, because I have the shop, I like to buy it because I can put new stuff on that shelf and give people new stuff to look at. So while I was doing this video, I had a guy buy two of the PS4 games. So I already got $10 back of it. I'll sell that box alone for like $35, $40. So that's the money back. And then I'll have 60 games to put on the shelf. And if they don't sell, they'll be at the flea market next year on a fire sale. The shoes you see me buy in the video, I bought those for my kids. Those are expensive shoes, those Band Bred ones and those Royal Blue ones. Jordan shoes can be expensive. I mean, to pay that much for them, and they were like, you know, near dead stock. I mean, they were super clean. So you got to be careful because there are a ton of fakes out there. I was trying to tell my dad to feel on them. A lot of times if you push on the where I was telling him to push on them, they'll be soft, like they'll imprint. Almost all the fakes that I've seen do that. So you just got to be kind of careful buying it. That girl had the receipt to them. Her story kind of added up, so, you know, and then I brought them back and they are real, so we're not going to sell them. I probably could resell them and make a little bit on them, but I just give those to my kids because I am a shoe collector and I like to give them shoes too, and they also like shoes. So once again, I want to appreciate everybody for tuning in. If you're not subscribed, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And also, make sure you tune in Friday because I broke my record on the most Silver Eagles I bought. So that's going to be in the Friday's video. So once again, I appreciate y'all, and I'll see y'all Friday.